I've always believed that the real way out of poverty is through jobs. You know, if you can create jobs and give people a source of real income, then poverty will take care of itself. What is missing in many of these places is opportunity. It's not that the people lack talent or ambition. I mean, it's almost universal that everybody in the world wants to work. Everybody wants to provide for their family. Everybody wants a better life for their children. That's universal in almost every country you go to. The opportunity may not be there. And I thought to myself, if you could find a way to create the opportunity, enable them, create the environment, people will work. I went to President Clinton, I said, you know what, I'm not happy. We're not doing enough. And he kind of agreed. And I said, I really want us to have a game changer. We need a game changer. We need something that will create jobs, something that is scalable, that you can take from a small operation and grow it and grow it and grow it. And most importantly, something that is transferable to other locations. So we need to create models of job creation that work and will work on a sustainable basis.
You know, I just loved him because he was so enthusiastic and he wanted to do all this. And I was overwhelmed when he told me that he was going to commit a huge amount of his life and a huge amount of his fortune to helping other people have their stories. And the thing I like about him is he's both idealistic and very hard-headed. So he doesn't want to waste his money and he doesn't want to waste his time. So he keeps looking for things that have, it's okay if we start small, as long as what we're doing can be repeated by us or by someone else on a grand scale, then that we know we're doing what the non-governmental organizations should be doing. And we think we've found it now.
Our approach is quite simple. We create businesses that remove all the obstacles that small farmers and producers face. Working capital, access to market, training, quality of output. We buy their produce, we consolidate into efficient supply chain, and we sell that to multinational partners, retail outlets, tourism sectors.
We've announced several initiatives that are very similar in nature. And what they address is filling the gap in the supply chain, okay? There is a demand, a market-driven demand for many products and services that exists in every country, and especially in countries that are growing in the area of tourism. The supply side is the part that has been unreliable from a local source. So what we wanted to address was the creating a reliable supply of products and services locally, where there is poverty.
We start all our ventures with a what we call a buy-side partner. So for example, if you're a large food and beverage company and you recognize the potential of a certain sort of sourcing area that is just too difficult and perhaps has too much social risk in it in terms of addressing. So these are areas where you're dealing with the very poor people of the world and a very sort of fragmented growing area. From their perspective, that's a problem for us, that's an opportunity. So there's immediately something complementary there.
That is, to train women entrepreneurs who were just good with people and knew how to do things, to sell products to people of the lowest income in the remotest villages at prices they could afford so we could improve their lives and improve the lives of the business community. That's what we're doing in Peru. And they don't have to come up with any front-end money. We get the products, they take them on consignment, and they are also more than doubling their income and helping the people in these remote villages. And the reason we wanted to do these things is that all three of these things are scalable. That is, we can eventually do it all over the country without an enormous expense.
In our distribution enterprises, we can do that in reverse. So if you look at the base of the pyramid, You know, there's a consumer market there comprised of billions and billions of people that most large retail businesses or manufacturers find it very difficult to get their products into. Many have attempted to unlock it through their own proprietary systems, distribution systems, where they're selling just their products. Our distribution systems have a much broader product range and service range, and therefore more commercially viable.
I've always believed, and I know Bill Clinton believes this, you have to do well by doing good. Otherwise, it's not sustainable. So if we can create a win-win situation for all participants, the suppliers, the buyers, you know, the donors, the corporate participants, I think the secret sauce to this approach is that it is a for-profit business, even though the profits are meant to be plowed back into a social enterprise of sorts. That's, it has to generate a profit. Otherwise, it will not be sustainable. You know, what people, I've seen a real change in the world of philanthropy. And I've seen it happen over the last 10 years. People that donate money, that put money into social projects, want to see a return. They want to see that it is, can generate its own existence as opposed to being funded continuously year after year. And quite frankly, I believe that's the only way it's going to work, is that it has to be sustainable on its own.
You can have a business that gives you a good economic return and a massive social return. And that's all it is. It's pretty simple. You know, we found an area where we think we can do that, and we just want to replicate it. You know, our goal is poverty alleviation at scale, and I think we have, you know, a very good chance of doing something like that.
For example, the warehouse that we visited today will actually earn a profit. Not a massive profit, but enough to give the investors back their money so they can reinvest it again if they want. And that's really important, because by the farmers being able and the fishermen being able to send their food to a warehouse that is partly working for them, that is, they get a bigger share of the ultimate sale price, but is also taking part of the sale price to keep that warehouse running at a profit. This can go on forever. And they can take more and more farmers in, more and more fishermen in. And it's the sort of thing that allows people at the so-called base of the economic pyramid to work their way into a middle-class life in these countries, and at a minimum to escape extreme poverty. So finally, I think we have an approach that reflects what Frank wanted to do when he made this commitment and what I want to do. With my foundation, I always say our job is to find ways to do things faster, cheaper, better, and then to work ourselves out of a job. Our happiest days ought to be when we leave a country because they don't need us anymore.
For me, the telling sign that we've done our job is the looks on their faces when they tell you about what this has done for them. It's given them dignity. It's given them an opportunity to provide for their families. And that's all anybody wants is, you know, dignity. And so if we can do that in all of these places, I already know, and I've had this conversation with President Clinton, and if you were to ask him, we both agree that we're onto something very innovative, very unique, and this is a game changer.